He invited me for the mission, mm-hmm. and I think in his mind he thought like, is that, I know she will not come.
Yes, because it's in most cases, we just do it for the sake of inviting her. Mm-hmm. But if we have a conference, why don't you turn up?
Mm-hmm.
And then that gets forgotten. They may turn up or they may not.
Yeah.
Or they will never say, I didn't invite you.
Yeah.
She came. That actually moved me. Mm-hmm. I was pleased. So now my interest has now started growing further.
Before that, he invited me the first day. Mm-hmm. I prepared myself to attend the conference.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
As usual, you know I love missions.
Mm-hmm.
Wait until now, you know, I don't know him.
Hello guys, it's your girl Patient Status. Welcome and welcome back to my YouTube channel. If it's your first time here, make sure you hit the subscription box and turn on the notification bell so that you're notified every time I post a new video. So today I have visitors for you, beautiful and awesome couple. For Faye, I've known her for 10 years. For Jose, I've known him since 2022.
2020.
Yeah. Yeah. So
4 years.
Yes. Yeah, so I'm going to give them an opportunity to introduce themselves, and they're gonna tell us their love story, how they knew each other, and how they have managed to come to this far. So welcome to my channel.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for accepting to be on my channel. So I'm gonna give you opportunity, introduce yourselves, tell us also where you come from. So I begin with
the head.
Ladies first.
My name is Faith Nduko.
Mm-hmm.
I'm born again. Love Jesus. I'm a beautiful lady married to this handsome man beside me. I'm a mother.
Proud
mother of two twins babies. They are 1 year, 3 months. Israel and Peter. And we thank God, we bless the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
I come from Kitui, yes.
Mm-hmm.
But I have so many origins.
But now?
You're regional.
Not really, not now. Forget about now. I was born in Machakos, Mwala.
Mm-hmm.
We moved to Kitui.
Mm-hmm.
And now,
back to
he took me back to home, to Machakos County.
Back to your roots.
Okay. So, that is my origin.
I'm Joseph Muteti. Mm-hmm. I'm born again. Married to this beautiful girl.
Mm-hmm.
She's the only one.
Hallelujah.
It's a matter of clarity.
Okay.
I come from Machakos, specifically Mwala.
Mm-hmm.
That's village. My land.
Mm-hmm.
Now the village and the rest is a story for another day.
Okay.
So tell us, for how long have you known each other? Leave alone dating.
Excluding dating.
Yeah. Or you started dating the moment you knew her.
Actually, there is no such a big difference between my point of knowing her and my point of dating her.
Yes.
Because after we met, I had actually, even before we had met, I had some ideas about this girl because.
Yes.
I had seen signs, eh?
Mm-hmm.
I had seen signs. Even before meeting physically.
Okay.
Yeah, because we used to engage. So it's not so long between the period now we met and knew each other and then the dating period.
So you knew her through online?
Maybe from our story they will get to know, how long we knew each other.
So how did you meet?
Basically, from 2018 to date.
That is when we met.
Yes.
So now, You know, men are by the end of your breaking the story.
Mm-hmm.
But we ladies, we give it the full how it is.
Mm-hmm. You give it a flow. Okay, you give it a flow.
So tell us, Faye, how did you...
We met physically in 2018, right?
Yes.
Around August.
Mm-hmm.
At a conference in the different church in Moja.
Mm-hmm.
Days of Refreshing.
Yeah.
He had invited me to come over.
Mm-hmm.
To attend the conference.
Yeah.
And as usual, you know, I love missions,
yeah,
conferences. So I attended, and that was the first time we met. Now, before we met, we used to be in the same WhatsApp group for Mwala Machakos County Youth.
Yes, the original one was called Family Joy.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
And then it grew too.
Now, after Family Joy,
mm-hmm,
we came to be in another one for Deliverance Church Youth, Mwala.
Mwala, yeah.
Yeah.
So I don't know why they had to have me in that group, because why? I'm from Kitui. Why was I in that group?
I think a friend just referred you to that group. That's what you do.
It was destiny to do. There is a friend we used to live with, and
mm-hmm,
she used to tell me about this group where they share more about the youth,
yeah,
our relationship matters,
mm-hmm,
waiting seasons,
mm-hmm,
like that. So she told me, you can be in this group. So good. So I was added in that group. Mahi, I'm from Kitui,
right,
but I'm in a group in Machakos County. Yeah. So that is how he got to know me. And in the process of sharing, talking, someone was looking at me and zooming me.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know that until
that time I invited you over. But before then, I and from the conversations,
yeah,
I could single out. Yeah, you can see from a general conversation,
mm-hmm,
this person is different. Yeah, I mean, you don't need much to look at, no.
Yeah.
So you can see before even before you meet this person,
mm-hmm,
you have a clue what kind of a person she is.
Mm-hmm.
So I could single her out, and then I thought, why don't we plan a meeting? Yes.
Maybe then did you have thoughts of you dating?
Dating?
Mm-hmm. Did you like him?
No, I had never seen him.
Mm-hmm.
We had never, in fact, I had not even saved his number.
Hmm.
Yes, I had not saved his number. So, in that group, we used to invite each other for maybe a church opening. You see, they are saying that we are having this conference. So, those that are available can meet and
yes,
attend the conferences.
Mm-hmm.
So, that is how we invited them. And then, before then, I think when we were clearing university, I hosted a mission from Musandamuliro to our home church.
Yeah.
And so I posted that. I think so. Yes, I posted there.
The group.
In the group.
Yes.
So that is the very first time,
mm-hmm,
you talked to me. Yes, that is the very first
I time. I used to follow up on the missions.
Follow up on me.
Almost every day, ask how are you doing, how are the missions going.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I don't know where I developed the interest from,
mm-hmm,
but I was just following up, and I could see this one.
So at what point now did you open up?
So at around by September, we had conversed, I had slid inbox, and we had been holding conversations. So from the group now, we are now having a two people conversation.
Mm-hmm.
So I invited her over, come to, we have this conference going on. I didn't know she would come.
In fact, Can I say that?
Go ahead.
He invited me for the mission, mm-hmm. and I think in his mind, he thought like, is that, I know she will not come.
Yes, because it's in most cases, mm-hmm. we just do it for the sake of inviting her. Mm-hmm. But if we have a conference, why don't you turn up?
Mm-hmm.
And then that gets forgotten. They may turn up or they may not.
Yeah.
Or they will never say, I didn't invite you.
Yeah.
She came. That actually moved me. Mm-hmm. I was pleased. So now my interest has now, started growing further.
Before that, he invited me the first day. Mm-hmm. I prepared myself to attend the conference.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
As usual, you know I love missions.
Mm-hmm.
Wait until now. You know, I don't know him. I'm still afraid. I cannot call him and tell him, lady, and where are you? I kept quiet. So I waited, and I was ready, prepared. So around 7, I'm like, is the conference still on?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you mean you were serious? You were to come?
And then
he had already forgotten that he invited me to attend the conference. I was so mad. In fact,
she didn't let me know she was mad.
Okay, I pretended.
But it happened that the next day, now she came. And I saw this serious person.
Mm-hmm. So it was me tomorrow. On a very serious note, tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
I do not forget. That is how we met now.
Yes, that's actually the first we met. From then, now followed coffee dates, more meetings, and more meetings. And today, still more meetings.
The admin for that group,
yeah.
is currently our best man.
Yes.
Yeah.
She or he?
They were.
They accomplished the mission.
A couple, yeah.
Okay, so tell us, Faye, the first time you went on a date with him, what was in your mind?
In my mind, I was just meeting a brother.
Mm-hmm.
From the same group,
mm-hmm.
but we are mm-hmm. in the same city, so we are just meeting to have a cup of tea,
mm-hmm.
and that's all. Until then, I had not even saved his number.
Mm-hmm.
So at what time did you know start dating officially?
That was after the conference.
Mm-hmm.
It did not take so long.
Yeah.
So we went out just a few times, and you know, there is this saying that says, if you keep escorting, if you hang around a beautiful lady,
mm-hmm.
and then you say nothing,
mm-hmm.
you'll end up fetching water in a body.
Yeah, sure.
So the meetings did not just remain meetings, mm-hmm. I decided to design my course.
Yeah.
Of course, I told her, look at you, look at me. We can form a good couple. So, let me tell you one mistake people do.
Mm-hmm.
They assume.
Yeah.
Say the word. It takes saying the word. Mkikubaliwa,
yeah.
Well and good. Mkikataliwa, sinivo. Hata chukua kiboko, akuchape.
Sure.
It's as much as being told. Yes. It's as much as being told. The worst you can be... the worst can be done to you is to be told no.
Yeah.
So nikarusha mistari yangu pale.
Mm-hmm.
1, 2. Ikuingiana saa hiyo hiyo, but mm-hmm. I would see some positivity.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So we went back and arranged another appointment. It was that serious, eh? So now in the next appointment,
mm-hmm.
It was confirmed. You see that J which comes with M-Pesa confirmed.
Mm-hmm.
By the end of 2018,
mm-hmm.
from November, we have now decided on the course. This is a course we are taking. You are very objective.
Mm-hmm.
In that relationship, our purpose.
Yeah.
have an end goal. Mm-hmm. Not just say, je tujaribu, mm-hmm. or kuwa chali yangu, kuwa manzi yangu. Mm-hmm. But then it ends at that. Mm-hmm. You know, that is now easy to just have it casually and break at any point and say, ah, see, tulikuwa tunajaribu tu atuko tunasema inaenda. But once you have a goal, we have said this, we are going to get married.
Yeah.
That is the goal. You have a goal that is driving you together, mm-hmm. and if both of you are for the purpose,
yeah.
to go ahead to succeed. So, officially, it began around November 2018. Yeah. yeah.
And not about now the proposal.
We proposed twice.
Twice?
Yeah.
Why?
Why did you propose twice?
I think, okay, not that I wasn't sure. But I was just excited.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But the best one, which touched even myself, was in 2019.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, 2019. Yeah. Well, it was Valentine's. I took that advantage.
Mm-hmm.
I proposed in church. There was a youth dinner.
Yeah, Valentine's.
Yeah. It was a Valentine's dinner. I took that advantage.
Yeah.
She did not know about it.
She was, were you praying or you were talking to the people? I think I saw it.
Yeah. They had invited me to speak about the relationships in the church. So while I was busy downloading.
Mm-hmm.
Then I hear claps and some noises. Looking back, my hands are manners behind me.
It really worked. Yeah, I loved it.
It was such a surprise.
Yes,
yeah, yes, but the first proposal was very serious. In fact, that is the one that I took really serious. But not to mean that the second one I didn't take it serious.
Mm-hmm.
But you see, this man comes to me and tells me, we can make a good couple. That was his proposal, imagine. Mm-hmm. We can make a good couple. And I'm like, who is this? He's already seeing us as a couple.
Yeah.
He's not telling me, can we try relationship?
Yeah,
can we try dating? And me, since when I was young, I didn't want to have a relationship that does not have a purpose. And I had this principle that any man that I accept in my life, it's either we are going towards marriage or you are not with me.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I'm not the kind of person who you come and try and bear up, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So when he came and told me that I was already seeing us as a couple,
mm-hmm.
okay. So I told him, when are you intending to get married?
Yeah, she asked me that.
That is when I asked him, when are you intending to get married?
Mm-hmm.
And then, who can I pack for gani?
Yeah.
Because, you see, kuna mtu anaweza kuja kupropose kwako, but hata ana plan ya life yake. And that is where the miss it. Mtu anakuja anataka date, but ana plan.
Yeah.
Ana plan ya vile anataka mfanye mpango yenu. Yeah. Then he told me, he said, okay, I'll check now my other aspects that I have to check.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
How about the wedding? When did you begin planning the wedding?
Almost immediately.
After the proposal?
Yes. The February one.
Yes. Even before that.
Mm-hmm.
Before now, the major plans which we discussed together.
Yeah.
There is that subtle plan. It's there, but it has not yet come out.
Yeah.
Even for a single person, you find they have this kind of wedding in their mind.
Mm-hmm.
It means, you know, actualizing it.
Yeah, sure.
So getting a person,
mm-hmm.
that is part of the now, the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
So, but after February, now the proposal, which is like a second confirmation.
Mm-hmm.
Now we start laying out plans, tentative dates for this and this, because you see, before our wedding, it does not just happen. You have to see your parents,
mm-hmm.
both sides.
Mm-hmm.
You have to be accountable to someone.
Mm-hmm.
You have to get an accountability partner, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
If possible, let them be your best couple.
Mm-hmm.
See the minister who will now oversee your wedding.
Mm-hmm.
And then you also have to involve the legal part of it, just to be recognized by the government. So those are the key things.
Mm-hmm.
Now the others, the aspect of crowds and having a grand wedding and having the best gown in town,
mm-hmm.
those come as secondaries.
Yeah.
Yes. But now the serious planning began after February of 2019.
Yeah, in fact, after that, we had another date where we set our principles, the do's and don'ts. We agreed on the best couple and our tentative wedding date. And then we set a date on when we are going to approach our best couple. And they really helped me. Big up, Mr.
Yes, big up to Mr. and Mrs. Paul,
yeah.
The pastor, Deliverance Church International, Kalama.
Kalama, yeah.
God bless you. Thank you very much.
They really helped us. Mm-hmm. They really helped us to lay the foundation for our marriage today. Yeah.
And how did you maintain purity before for wedding?
From that point of setting boundaries, the do's and don'ts.
Yeah.
You see, that helps you. Because if you don't have boundaries and principles,
yeah.
you end up doing anything because you don't have something guiding you.
Yeah,
even if you find yourself in a mess, it's because of it ended up just casually because people say, Matusifanyi hivi. But now you end up messing. So, biblically, there should be no sex before marriage. There is no aspect of testing. That is a thing of the world. As a believer, as a Christian, you have to be serious about it. No sex before marriage. That is one thing we said very clear.
Yeah.
And said we avoid compromising situations.
Yeah.
Yeah, because you see, when you have now begun a thing, the two of you now are very close.
Yeah.
And you're very prone to even attacks from the enemy.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's people who give the enemy a chance.
Yeah.
But yourself, you protect yourself in such a way.
Yeah.
You're not prone to temptations.
Yeah.
Yeah. So,
I think
the Bible says flee from lustful desires.
Yeah.
So, you avoid, you don't brave them.
Yeah.
Yes, yes.
These three things helped us. We had accountability partners, that is our best couple. Prayer. Prayer can kill the thirst for sin. It does kill. And then we set our principles. In fact, we wrote them.
We wrote them down.
We wrote them down. And the principles should not come from one end. There should be an agreement between the two. So we sat down, agreed. Can you wait? I can also wait. So we agreed on the do's and don'ts, and we wrote them down, sent them in our emails. And we used to review them one by one, oftenly. Yes.
And how about having a wedding on during COVID? So during COVID, right?
Yeah.
What are the challenges that you went through?
We had advantages and disadvantages at the same time.
But let me say this. We saw the grace of God.
Yeah.
You can imagine, just when we have begun, that was 2018.
Yeah.
Through 2019, almost at the end of 2019, everything has been good.
Mm-hmm.
you hear there is this disease that has come. So you can imagine, we have seen it from the beginning when it was now coming out. From when it is entering Kenya, the first case, the panic, and now it's like there are no gatherings. All those things found us in the course of planning. Everyone was masked. All that. So, it happened later in 2020 because we were planning for a wedding in April. But then came the lockdown. So we had to postpone. I can remember my girl here was almost depressed now. But I gave her the encouragement. We used to wait those announcements that the Cabinet Secretary for Health has come out to announce. But
no opening.
The hardest knock usually came when the president was not speaking. And if you want to either give the end to the lockdown or continue. Then now comes the point of being all been waiting for. The lockdown has been continued for the next 30 days.
30 days.
We are like now. All right, let's be patient. No traveling, no one coming from the reserve is coming to Nairobi. We wait for the next phase. The lockdown continues. The one that was worst was not even given a timeline. No 30 days, no 6 days. It was until further notice.
Until further notice. That was when? In March?
No, that was now after we had already postponed the first day. So towards sometime in July, it was at least east. Some of the counties were open. And now we say, we won't wait for too long. Let's do this. Let's invite the most key people. Our parents, a few friends. And then came another reprieve. Now the government said, okay, enough gatherings, but
must.
They must be masked and they have to be a limit of 50 people. We said, okay, why don't we have parents and the official minister, our best couple, and then friends on a basis of invite one. But I tell you, there was so much grace that we could not limit people to 50. And for the doctors, there was no case of COVID transmission. To save us, there were no the aspect of cooking for people was not yet allowed. We only did a smaller lot, so that was also a saving on the part of our pocket.
Because the financial contribution was also very low, because everyone would keep the little that you have, you keep, because you don't know what is happening tomorrow.
People are doing more on saving than spending.
It was tough. I really didn't want my parents to miss my wedding. I didn't want so. And I had a lot of friends who wanted to attend the wedding. Like, for example, we had 16 maids. The good thing with us, we take everything positive and we appreciate. We know times and seasons belong to God. So I need to bear grace that time. Like a who was smart. It was nice. I honestly say that the weddings that were done during COVID, I think mine was good.
It was
yes, and I'm proud of that.
I really enjoyed the day.
You did, I remember. You danced. And also it was very hard to limit people to 50. Minister, utaitage asisikie hiyo.
You are more than 100, right?
Yeah, you are many baby.
You are more than 100.
But the space was there.
Yeah, the space was there.
The church was big.
Yeah.
We danced. I was so happy.
So after the wedding now, how was the stay after? Like, did you have the pressure? You know, the way people are pressured to do, you should now have kids. Did you have that kind of pressure?
It's normal. Yeah, it comes. We are Africans. And, you know, for the African parents and African generally, Africans, sisi tunaamini ya kwamba wewe ukishaolewa kesho, tunafaa tuanze kuona dalili.
Let the counting begin.
Let the counting begin. So that's yet another plan. So, we had to just take, you know.
Yeah, you don't let other people dictate your plans.
And exactly. And leave our own.
So after how long did you have the twins?
We had our twins.
Twins came after around 3 years.
Two points. Because we celebrated our third anniversary when they were 2 months three months. So we celebrated our third anniversary when they were 3 months.
So 3 years something, we got them.
Yeah.
And you were okay with that.
So how was the pregnancy journey for you, Joseph?
Oh, for me?
Mm-hmm. Yes. Oh, you were not pregnant.
No, like how walikuwa nakuambia kuna craving ya nataka mchanga usiku.
Ni kwanza naona watu wanakula mawe, yes, ndio na.
What was a craving?
Watu kula mawe naona karibu wanavunja matofali ya nyumba. So for her, okay, you see, I also fed her well. Kukula mawe huko na nini na mtu ya. You are lacking
iron.
Scientifically, you are lacking zinc.
Yeah.
And calcium.
Mm-hmm.
And some other important minerals.
Mm-hmm.
But so you see, you don't get them, the body has to ask.
Mm-hmm.
So especially huko Shago, unaona mama anapita, akipata kile ki what is nagira kivoa ile anti.
Yeah.
Anapita na kitovali hapo Anaenda kimomunya.
Mm-hmm.
And I guess it tastes so sweet to their mouths because you see they enjoy it. Mm-hmm. But when you have done enough a well balanced diet,
mm-hmm.
you don't have some of those cravings.
Yeah, okay.
But at one or two points,
mm-hmm.
now the hunger comes with a lot of violence.
Mm-hmm.
Ja. Mobile. Let me tell you, several times in the supermarket, we have bought a cake or something edible. By the time you get into the counter, she's presenting the package. This is the package.
It was that bad.
And then I do a bake. So they look at cake, and I play in Karatazi College, and you go down here. But then because it's written, it's coded,
yeah.
They'll just scan the package and then
just look at me,
my friend. But I understand it. There are two people inside there.
Yeah, sure.
And by the way, today we have them bouncing and kicking, and we thank God.
Yeah.
So, with all those challenges, I embrace them because that's something we pray for.
Yeah.
And when you have planned for something and you're waiting for it, you don't feel the burden.
Mm-hmm.
But you take it as a good challenge.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, so I would say the pregnancy journey was cool.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So you
put a cock of sugar? I'm going to go to the cock. Such times, as in a when I do too, remember some of it coming was a windy now. Put on bony,
yeah.
Okay, go very slowly and very carefully. So I would be sure you would crawl. Again, a Mali Napangia. past the normal time now, I exceed some minutes or hours.
Yeah. So for you, Faye, how was it?
I can say it was smooth. Considering immediately imagine you are carrying twins. It is termed as a delicate pregnancy.
Yeah.
But for us it was smooth. I can say so. We have never gotten sick.
Mm-hmm.
There is no time that I felt sick at our home.
Mm-hmm.
All through the 9 months staying got taken into ningeenda clinic na ada single men's of 5 minutes up on that. But the only things to be got mafanya mostly in scans in a kwanga more.
Yeah.
Like we did a man scans. We used to do scans like after 3 to 2 months.
So many, I can't even remember.
So I think we did six. Not six, around five. Five. Nah, it was smooth. Me, Brenda, it was so supportive, baby. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. It was so supportive. I developed a very good appetite for sleep and food. So that was the only major thing. Me, nilikuwa mtu na enjoy. I used to work. I worked until when I was how many months? Around 2 weeks to deliver. But then nilikuwa naenda job, nilikuwa tu sawa. Kulala tu ndio ilikuwa mingi. Kulala na njaa. So he used to ensure that every Sunday ama kama tunaenda mahali, he must ensure that I have a dish in my handbag.
Yeah.
I remember to toast my eye.
Without that, they would get bad.
Na to my dodo, to the yellow beans. That he used to feel good with them. So he was so supportive. And you know, men carry pregnancy in their mind.
Yeah, sure.
During that period, he used to work away from Nairobi, but I used to see him commute from as far as Central to come to Nairobi to ensure that he has to sleep home and tomorrow he has to wake up and go back to Central. Somewhere along the way, he got an accident at night around, he got to the house around 2 a.m. with mud everywhere, blood everywhere. I was like, he's sacrificing all this because of me. Could tell him sometimes just rest. I could just take care. Don't bear. I'm big. Yeah. But I was so happy. Because of that emotional support, he prayed for me, encouraged me that it's going to be well. Sometimes we mothers, you know, but I'm going to see the anxiety. My baby is doing. Please. A very positive man.
Yeah.
Always. Hata kama uko mgonjwa uniambia. Ukiuliza na mtu uko aje, usianze na ugonjwa. Yeah. Sema, niko poa lakini niko mgonjwa.
Yeah.
So he used to encourage me so much. He supported me so much.
Yeah.
Until now, he's very supportive. And I'm happy for that.
Huh?
Uh-huh. Yeah, I didn't choose him.
Yeah, sure.
Yes. Or you didn't choose?
Oh, don't say, you know. If there is one person who is very selective, it's her.
I know.
So, me being one among her choices, I passed a very serious exam.
But they told me so.
Yeah.
Even asked me that before we got married.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. We are so strict. How did I qualified, because yeah, you had all, I used to mark my register, this one, born again, yes, and some obvious,
everything
can fall in place, very ample,
yeah,
and I like that.
But still, do not have a very long list of qualifications. You see, that is the... No, I just appreciate that because those are the key things.
Mm. Did I have a long one?
You start with the key one, like... you start with the believer's point of view.
Yeah. It is very important.
He is a believer.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That is number one qualification.
Mm-hmm.
Now we go to next.
Mm-hmm.
So, as I said, those are now like secondary. But you see, some of these our ladies.
Yeah.
We love them, yeah, but you have to correct them.
Mm-hmm.
The list is long. In let's say early 20s.
Mm-hmm.
As you grow,
then they catch you.
You come and look at this list again.
This one. Turn back and
that's
not very, very important.
It goes shortening and shortening.
Mm-hmm.
Just have the key.
Yeah, sure.
After the key things,
mm-hmm.
the rest, you know, you're not bringing this person to change the person.
Yeah.
You grow as you mold one another.
Yeah. And you can find everything in one person.
Yes, you can.
Another thing, you cannot know a person fully.
Mm-hmm.
Because the way you think at 18 is not the way you think at 20.
Yeah.
The way you think at 25 is not the way you think at 35.
Mm-hmm.
You are growing and changes keep coming.
Mm-hmm.
If you chose this person because of the way he or she was at that point,
yeah.
how will you handle the same when the change comes?
Yeah, sure.
Yes. Very important.
Yeah. Again, you keep learning every day.
Mm-hmm.
You cannot say that you have known this person on everything.
Yeah.
Until today, there are things I'm still learning from him.
Yeah, sure.
How many years down the line? I think four years down the line. Kuna vitu nanga, yeah. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
The other day, you were talking to our bishop and he was telling me, do you think you have known him fully? No. We are at around 50 years in marriage.
Yes.
Na bado kuna vitu na learn. So,
yeah, sure.
Uwezi sema umeona, umejua mtu kila kitu. Uwezi,
yeah.
unamujua mtu mkiendelea.
Mm. So now comes the thing during the delivery day. How was that day? Were you tense or something? Did you have anxiety?
Yes. I forgot to tell you something.
Mm-hmm.
During this time, during our pregnancy,
mm-hmm.
our twins were an answered prayer. We really wanted twins.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, we had names before marriage or immediately after that is when we discussed about kids before we got married.
Yes, because that's when you told me from before you've been, you love twins.
Twins, yes.
Also be specific in prayers. God,
yeah.
God answers those specifications. Yes.
Yeah. So I loved twins.
Yeah.
Ever since Kitambo San.
Mm-hmm.
So they came as an answered prayer, and we used to pray that we get twins,
mm-hmm.
a boy and a girl,
yeah.
and we set the names.
Yeah.
So after we learned we were pregnant,
mm-hmm.
I learned before him.
Mm-hmm. How did you break
I learned him? Before him.
No, just in brief,
yeah.
you know, she was with her friends, and now I think she bothered. I don't know how they came up with the idea.
Mm-hmm.
They usually took me in rounds in this house.
Mm-hmm.
You see that that kind of treasure hunt. It's kind of
yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm.
So I come here, I find a knot.
mm-hmm.
So do you look below under the table?
Mm-hmm.
I check another knot.
Mm-hmm.
Now the knot is sending me to the sink.
Mm-hmm.
I go to the sink thinking I'll find whatever I am being taught.
Uh-huh.
Another knot.
Mm-hmm.
My friend, I went in rounds.
Mm-hmm.
I did at last. You see what I came to find last?
Taken mm-hmm. to the bedroom.
In the bedroom.
Mm-hmm.
Inside an inflated balloon.
Wow.
With some, what do you call them? Some sparkles.
Mm-hmm.
Pregnancy test kit. Testing positive.
You knew how it is when it's positive.
Okay.
Or you guessed.
No, I knew.
Mm-hmm.
Because I think we had tested before,
okay.
but it was negative.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if that was part of the prank or what.
Mm-hmm.
But this one was even, I tell you, it comes with such a great news.
Mm-hmm.
Like it's almost unbelievable. Until I looked very keenly to see this thing is not written.
Written by pen.
Yeah, but it was not marked, it was real. It was such a
it was 2022 Father's Day.
that is when I
such a perfect time.
And that is when I wished him happy Father's Day, father of twins.
The very first.
You already knew it's twin.
No. It was,
you guess.
You see,
by faith.
By faith.
By faith. Mm-hmm. In fact, all throughout our life, we have lived by faith and favor and the grace of God. It was by faith.
You see, if you have faith,
yeah.
It's not your business to know if it happens or not.
Oh, yeah,
not.
Sure. It is a business.
There are these young men in the Bible, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. They told the king, our God, you need to, you throw us into the burning furnace.
Yeah.
Our God, whom we serve, will deliver us.
Yeah.
They had faith.
Mm-hmm.
But they told him, even if he does not deliver us, we shall still not bow down to your God. So, what's your faith? The rest of the business is what?
Yeah. He had been away for like 1 week. So, when he was coming back, I had already tested and knew that. Now I'm preparing for this Father's Day.
He
was so busy, so he was not even thinking of the Father's Day. That is how I came now to surprise him with notes and took him to the bedroom. And I ensure that when he entered the house, he did not go to the bedroom. So I don't know, I put a movie here or there. So, and I ensure that I'm engaging him around here to ensure that everything is set in the bedroom. I had already said. So before we took supper, that is when I dropped the first note. Yeah, and then
that was just creative.
Yeah, so we went, checked. It was amazing. It was good. Yeah, I was also happy. At that point, we didn't know we were expecting twins. We were just trusting God. And if it doesn't happen, it is well.
So the day you learned about the twins, how was the
reaction? Yeah. We learned that we were having twins on our first clinic, right?
Yeah,
yes, the very first clinic we went. At around 4 weeks, that is when there is a way they do the scans and they can see. We were so happy. I cried. I was so happy. Even the next day when traveling to work, I was still shedding some tears of joy because I was really happy.
Yeah.
I even took some photos.
So now during the delivery.
Where are those photos?
I have them. Then my Google photos.
You never sent them to him.
Yes. You didn't see. I thought I was crying.
Yeah, it's just that at work. I saw them way back. I need to look.
I didn't ask a selfie.
So, myself, I was so overjoyed. I didn't know how to react.
The gender.
I was just speechless.
Yeah.
The gender, you knew the gender the same day.
So the gender was the next step.
Around 20 weeks when we were doing a Stanford anomaly scan to check the organs, the body organs of the growing. Then he found that a girl is here, a boy is here.
I just thanked God.
He was so excited.
Mm-hmm.
He also cried, baby.
Yes.
You did? I saw myself here because
it was such a day.
Yeah. In fact, all the scans we went, the first one, we were so excited to see that they were twins. The second one, we went at 20 weeks, now we saw the gender, and we were like, but then during that pregnancy journey, we saw God in a very serious way.
Mm-hmm.
Mungu, you are like this. Mungu naweza fanya hii. It was nice. Then now, during delivery, I was so scared. So scared. Because I was really scared of CS.
Yeah.
Because I fear cats. I really fear cats. So in that room, I was getting nervous. I was sweating because you are kept in a certain room for the antibiotics to take the antibiotics. Na nilikuwa peke yangu kwa hiyo karoom. Hai nikaona vile naendelea hapa ni kama nitaanza kuogopa.
Wasi wanalao your closest person.
You see, sasa tuko kwa nimeshawaacha kwa kwa room, kwa hiyo room tungepeleka watoto. So nimepeleka huko kwingine karibu na vieta. So niko tu hapa. Daktari tu anakuja anakuwekea kengine na naenda. You stay there for like around 20 to 30 minutes. Hai, nikafungua simu nikaweka tumiungo tu nikaanza kuimba nikiomba. Nikafungua curtain, so I was just watching the guy goes, could you distract me?
Yeah.
Alafu. Then came now my turn. Nikambona, let's go. Tukaenda. Kwenda kuingia that theater room. It's a closed room kadogo. Hai, watu hapa wamejivaa tu. Alafu my lights. Hapo ndio sasa nilitense kabisa. Nikasikia ni kama mwili hata nikawa na freeze. I was like, hi. Nikaekewa hiyo sindano, the God what?
The anesthetic.
I laid there. Now, before I went to the theater room, because I had my phone in that other room. So nikaambia nasi mmoja hapo anishikie simu. Akaenda kwa our private room kuniletea nguo. Then he came back and told me, where? Huko kwa hiyo room umewashwa maombi. He had gone with a friend of ours and our reverend mom. Ndiye tulikuwa na wao huko. So kumbe wao waliingia kwa hiyo room, they are really praying for me.
Yeah.
Nasa nguja akaniambia, madam, msishtuke, huko kumewashwa maombi.
Yeah.
Nikajua okay. Hata mimi nikajutia nguvu kabisa. At that point, I was just waiting to get my babies because nilikuwa nimeanza kuchoka. Nilikuwa nimechoka kabisa by 38 minutes, I was so tired. Ili hata siku wangia kushuka hiyo stairs na kupanda tena na hiyo mimba.
Yeah.
And then tukaenda, tukamaliza vizuri. I don't know, mimi nikisikianga tu.
Enjoy.
But I felt so good. So good.
Such a nice feeling.
Yeah.
After prayers, just a very little tension, minimal.
Mm-hmm.
After prayers, I was at ease because I felt reassurance.
Yeah.
Yeah. And it turned out so, and it thanked God.
So we had to talk and come to appear at a pitch. Immediately.
Unatoka immediately.
Ukitoka theater unaekwa recovery room. Una relax kidogo because that time you can't walk. Yeah. So unakaa hapo kidogo ndio at least ukuwe unaweza kusimama. It turned out good. Thank God.
Years later
they are big people now. They are running all over here. If they were
very
here,
nice.
If they were here right now, it would be
see
and take him back up there.
You're going to be the farthest thing you can.
And yeah. Are you guys planning for more babies?
Oh,
when we finish chapter, when God's plan,
I know you are. From the treatment you received.
Okay, by the way, there is a time I was telling him. Kama treat ndo hii, kama tutaongeza
hivi tena.
Lakini we!
That is it.
This can also be enough.
Yeah. They are enough, baby.
So what are some of the challenges like in maybe you're facing? I am married.
Ama wakuja tena
my hip bone is still aching.
So you have talked about challenges.
Yeah.
The challenges are there in marriage.
Yeah.
Because these are two people who have been brought together in different backgrounds.
Yeah.
So first the adapting. Yeah. It's usually the first challenge.
Yeah.
Because unaonanga kama mnaishingi hivi. Mhm. Love you kwa wanaishingi hivi.
Yeah.
So you have to find a way to blend.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Na pia personalities.
Personalities.
Men and ladies. Yeah. Totally different.
Mm-hmm.
Very different.
Hey.
So it's a lot of adjustments. Out of that will come differences.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Sometimes you argue, sometimes you have to discuss and come to an argument.
Mm-hmm.
So that's another challenge because you're used to making decisions alone.
Mm-hmm.
Now you are the two of you.
Yeah.
So it can also happen because there might be someone in this case that you think you are being so much you post on.
Yeah.
You think you are being too much or stressed.
Mm-hmm.
Or over-monitored.
Yeah.
But with time, it now comes to flow.
Mm-hmm.
You know that as I make my decisions, I have to first time in my partner. Yeah. Because
I hear digesting. Unapata umepanga nguo vizuri, umeheka, amekuja ametafuta shati moja na iko tu hapa chini ya hii ya kwanza.
Mm-hmm.
ametafuta ametoa zote akaeka hapa.
Mm-hmm.
Akachukua ile alikuwa anataka. Mm-hmm. Na akaziacha hapo. Ukichukua uwezi rudisha tu penye ziko.
Kuna zingine zinakunjuka.
Nilisahau.
No, sometimes you see you're in a hurry, sasa.
Yeah.
You might come, si utakuja kupanga baadaye.
What was that one worst agreement you had?
You're still adjusting.
Oh, one thing with us, we don't like getting to a serious argument.
Mm-hmm.
Because we believe that when you get married, you are one thing.
Yeah.
And you should not be arguing to win,
mm-hmm.
but arguing to
get the solution.
Mm-hmm. To get the solution.
Mm-hmm.
See, the problem with many people
mm-hmm.
is arguing like you are competing. Like okay. You are two people who are competing
mm-hmm.
for my view to win,
yeah.
not yours.
Mm-hmm.
But it should be you are arguing to get the solution to this. So we don't like. And it has worked for us that mm. kama umekosewa you just sit down. Nimefanya hii na hii by the way. Ah, siku anajua kama nimekosea. Okay, sorry. Hii inaisha.
Mm.
But ile akurushiana maneno wewe na wewe ukafanya hii na wewe ukafanya hii. No, we don't allow that. Hata kama umesikia umekosewa aje.
Mm.
Yeah, we don't like, in fact, ana tunaweza amua tu kama unasikia umekasirika sana na you cannot talk that time.
Mm.
Take time. We'll come to talk about it later.
Yeah. When you are
disagreements are there.
Yeah.
Only that arguments should not be.
Yes.
Because when you are arguing, it's like you're fighting.
Yeah.
When you're all intentional
mm.
about it,
mm.
it's better for you.
Yeah.
And that's what Ranga, our best couple, they have helped us.
Very much.
To know that we ourselves can solve problems by ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't have to get to the extreme.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't have to get to your parents knowing and letting a third party.
Yeah.
You two are very sufficient to solve your own problems.
Because in marriage, misunderstandings are always there.
Mm-hmm.
He has different personalities, I have different. So you realize that many times you disagree.
Yeah.
And you are grown ups by the way. Yeah, so you cannot be thinking the same thing
yeah.
as much as you are one.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So the only thing we should do, people should work on is not prolonging the misunderstanding to an argument,
yeah.
but working towards getting a solution to that. Yeah.
So I think we have come to the end. Now you want to tell us the channel you want to begin, the YouTube channel.
Oh.
In fact, we took the challenge.
Yes.
Very fast.
I'm challenging you.
You have fresh here, she can
fresh
help
you
us.
Really challenge us on opening
can,
a YouTube channel.
You should.
She can do some mentorship.
Welcome to pick up for girls super.
Abisa.
Oh.
We'll think about it, and if the moment we open it, we'll
talk to you. Are you ready to start mentally?
Are you ready to edit to make
it at your service?
Yeah.
Soon you will see us on YouTube.
Yeah, once they begin the channel, guys, I'm gonna inform you as well. Mm. I hope you have learned something from their love story.
Mm.
Yeah, so if you have any, maybe a question, you can write on the comment section as well. Maybe they tell us their social handles. Facebook.
Facebook is just my official name, Joseph Muteti.
Okay. And mine, Faith NM, Joseph.
Will you change the dad?
Yeah, it's still there. It's still there. It got to Apochinia. Faith NM.
Faith
Dan. No, that I mean, that was the name.
Yeah, I still own that name. The Dan. Dan is my father's name. Mm-hmm. So I'm happy about that.
Actually, we used to be in the same campus.
Yeah.
Since first year, the same hall.
It's so encouraging you have kept that friendship.
Yeah,
it's been amazing.
One thing I can tell people is that there is no a documented blueprint for a perfect match.
Yeah.
A perfect match depends on yourself. You know what you can handle?
Yeah.
You see, there are things you can handle that I can't.
Mm-hmm.
A perfect match is that person when you can connect.
Mm-hmm.
You can connect deeply.
Yeah.
Deep kabisa.
Mm-hmm.
Ile. How do I put it?
You can feel it.
You can feel that unexplainable.
Yeah.
Connection.
Mm-hmm.
But hakuna ile at kuna perfect match imeandikwa mahali, this is perfect match. Obviously kuna zile vitu za kawaida, you cannot date a womanizer, you cannot date a violent man, you cannot date a violent lady. Kuna hizo vitu tu general. Then there are the rest of the things that you personally consider. Mimi naweza handle hii. Easy and the person that you can connect physically, you can connect spiritually and mentally. Spiritually, the Bible says that two cannot walk together unless they agree.
Yeah.
It is advisable that if you are born again, it is advisable to also get someone who can connect spiritually. Isikuwe sasa mnangangania, ni mimi nitaenda club na watoto. Hapana, ni mimi nitaenda church na wao. Hapana, leo tuende club. Hapana, leo tuende hii. Hapana, tusifanye hii. You see? So you need someone that you can connect spiritually, you can also connect mentally. A person that is not afraid of your strength.
Yeah.
Akiona, you are an engineer, a degree holder, an engineer. Your perfect match, aezi kuwa yule mtu anakuonea wivu. Mimi nimfanya hii, huyu. Ana feel threatened na strength zako, ni kama ataki utafute kazi. You see, something like that. A person that is not, doesn't take your weaknesses.
Yeah.
It doesn't take them against you.
Mm-hmm.
Like, he or she can work towards perfecting your weaknesses, helping you improve on them.
Mm-hmm.
A perfect match can also be the person who can help you build on your strength.
Yeah.
Like for example, tuseme umesomea hii, anaweza ku encourage ama ameona. Like he used to tell me, you know, you can make a good lawyer.
Yeah.
Used to tell me so. And recently he has been and also encouraging me on so many things, like academic wise, work wise, and appreciating also my strength.
Yeah.
So akuna mali imeandikwa this is the perfect match.
Sure.
Perfect match depends on you.
Mm-hmm.
The only thing that you should check is someone who can connect with you physically.
Mm-hmm.
Inakuwa hata mnaweza ongea. I was listening to someone who was saying that kuna mtu alimwambia like hata wakiwa ina meeting aone tu bwanake ameinua macho inawe, he will know that jamaa anataka tu you can communicate na inaitwa you are connected.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah,
that's amazing. Some wise words hapo.
To the young couples too, we have a word.
To the young couples, it's a long journey, as included.
Yeah.
We have a some journey ahead.
Yeah.
And once we begin with God, we continue with God.
Yeah.
You end with God.
Sure.
Yes.
So that's it, guys. Thank you so much for the amazing time, for the wise words. Yeah, we really look after you guys. And we are proud of you and of this far that you have come. And we can't wait to see more babies.
Ah? Okay.
To see the family grow, to see you, you know, growing old together and celebrating more anniversaries. Yeah, so that's it, guys. Make sure you like, share, comment, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss any time I post a new video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'm gonna see you on my next video. Bye.
Cheers! Cheers to gray hairs.
Thank you very much. Cheers to many more.
To many more.
Years and decades.